Alright, this is gonna be a pretty quick video, but I just wanted to share a short little project that I worked on in college. For my machine learning class, towards the end of the semester, let's just say the grades in the class from the homeworks and the exams, not just my grades, mind you, they weren't looking too pretty. So with that in mind, our professor was feeling particularly generous with extra credit, and he gave us this assignment. He's basically like, hey, there's this blog post by Andrej Karpathy that's super famous. There's a good chance you've seen it, or some other project that uses it yourself already. But basically, he's talking about a recurrent neural network that takes as input a sample of text, and it'll learn from that sample input and generate an endless sequence of text that's all similar in structure and syntax to the original. So, for example, if you feed it the complete works of Shakespeare, it'll generate you a bunch of text that kinda, sorta looks like English in the style of Shakespeare. And that was basically our assignment. Feed this neural network a corpus of text from Project Gutenberg, see what it spits out, and do a short write-up about our observations. But what I found more interesting was the network's ability to understand not just the syntax of English, but pretty accurately recreate the syntax of code, programming, and markup languages. So here's an example from the blog post. He fed the neural network a bunch of LaTeX markup, and it was able to spit out a giant stream of actually parsable LaTeX. And here, he fed it a bunch of Linux source code files, and it started outputting syntactically valid C. Obviously, in this case, the code didn't compile, but given a language whose syntax is flexible and simple enough, theoretically, it could make something actually usable. So I started thinking about what language would be a good fit for this network when I remembered one of my favorite software toys, DECTalk.
Hello. My name is Perfect Paul.
DECTalk is a speech synthesizer from the 80s that used to be used, for example, by automated telephone systems or by the disabled to help them communicate. You might know it best as the voice of the National Weather Service.
Out here is the hazardous weather outlook for portions of eastern and central Missouri as well as west central and southwest Illinois.
Or the voice of Stephen Hawking.
I am delighted and honored to receive a special prize in fundamental physics.
Although actually, now that I think about it, you probably know it best as the default speech synthesizer in Unreal Engine.
Holla holla get dollar. John Madden, John Madden, John Madden, John.
Now, DECTalk used to be a piece of hardware that you connected to a computer with a serial cable. But these days, you can find software implementations that work well enough to play around with.
Good enough, lol.
DECTalk was designed to be very versatile, and to that end, it has a powerful but simple syntax for controlling various properties of the synthesized voice. It's actually possible to specify specific phonemes, pitches, and durations to make DECTalk sing. Here's a quick sample of DECTalk singing and the code that makes it happen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear DECTalk. Happy birthday to you.
Now, I've never had the patience to actually sit down and transcribe a song phoneme by phoneme for DECTalk to sing. But wouldn't it be great if we could just get the neural network to do the work for us? So, I downloaded a corpus of DECTalk songs from the internet, concatenated them together into one big long file, and just sort of plugged that into the neural network with all the default settings to see what would happen. After 1,000 training steps, these were the initial results.
90,006 cleaver, bananum, goi, doots, angela, wavers, commander in phoneme, 200.
Well, it's clearly got some notion of what a DECTalk song should look like, and it even starts to sing, but the neural network just makes too many syntax errors to keep up. So I decided to let it train for a while longer, and after 20,000 steps, this was the result.
Friend glory, see it really, I am longs, the friendly glory, He's Olivia just and Jesus for an lazy.
Impressed just slightly. And praise the Father John Hyatt.
Now that's interesting. The network no longer makes any major syntax errors, and it's starting to make sounds that kinda sound like words. In fact, if you listen closely, you can hear it say words like glory and Jesus. Has our computer inexplicably gained an understanding of religion? Well, if you look at the source of the sample songs I found online, you'll see that about 46% of it is classified as gospel music, with another 5% being Christmas music. So it's only natural that the network would learn how to form words like these. It's not necessarily the type of music I would have chosen, but it's what I had on hand, and it certainly leads to some interesting results. Next up, here's the results after 43,000 training steps.
Tell Carl runs our ring again. What? Let about our here I cuffled. And I have for it am got is across the corn and the love from heaven. That's more lords a miry. How done the life was kings me the these red. How the like of him you and heaven and I stands and I put this brand.
At this point, you could even start to call the results musical. However, they're still not perfect, and the network is occasionally producing syntax errors that just end up screwing up the entire rest of the output. So I decided to tweak the settings of the network, making it larger, and since I was running out of time for the assignment, running it on a large GPU-accelerated EC2 instance. Here's the results of the new network after 10,000 iterations.
There's the mooning into from Dex Purple Evrons. Meet her the way. Sing it, grease somebody gone. Mention of love, and she want to warn 10 late. Before I and the good ocean come. Some bills above on me in your holy are made in on the loving me so strong.
The output definitely has a musical quality to it now. It's also started picking up on larger words like Beelzebub. No surprise where it learned that word from. What's interesting, though, is that while you might just expect the network to overfit and copy sequences of characters verbatim from the input files, it's actually singing these words at different pitches. It seems to understand at some level that there's a separate relationship between consecutive phonemes and consecutive pitches, almost as if it was actually singing. And remember, I never taught it about those relationships at all. All it was given was strings of text, and it had to figure out all these relationships on its own. Pretty neat, huh? Lastly, here's one more sample output with a few different settings tweaked.
Some break us wood nine's trees and pray the soon be crest her fellow love every but's time. Sing, say king away, praise of his love. Jesus net train the fray down and three drowns. So I'm cross the bass and light a loss of will. Sunny I feel blue in steel, how I thirsty.
Anyway, that's all I've got for now. There are a bunch of links in the description, including the unedited output from the neural network if you want to hear these songs in full, as well as links to the original blog post, which you should definitely read if you haven't already, and the ready-to-use Docker image we used for the class if you want to play around with it yourself.
Obviously, my little project was very much a surface-level exploration, so I encourage anyone who's interested to play around with this stuff themselves. It's a ton of fun. And of course, I love to see the numbers go up. So if you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing and following me on Twitter.